FUSETRA is a program supported by the EC, as you know, and we started the program just 3 months ago. And the objective of the program is to first to collect data to look what happens in Europe and worldwide in seaplane operation. And the first workshop, which we organized just now here in Biscarrosse, and we are very happy that the Lord Mayor of Biscarrosse and also the organization of the event was supporting us from the very beginning, that we had a good audience and a good basis to start without the discussion in seaplane operation. You know that seaplane operation in Europe is not very common. In other parts of the world, in Canada, North America, or Maldives and so on, you have a lot of traffic there. But in Europe, there are only a few operators, commercial operators. There are a lot of fun operators, I will call. That means operators with smaller airplanes, operators looking to get some people on board for tourist reasons, so on, but not in the sense of scheduled flights, even not scheduled tourist flights. And in the commercial area, several companies tried in the past to build up an operation, especially on the Mediterranean side. The Mediterranean, you know, it's a wonderful environment for touristic, but also a lot of islands there, also for business transportation from one island to the other. And we saw that a lot of companies went into bankruptcy or failed and finally gave up. That was one part of the story. The other part of the story is that the EC terminated and a strategy for Europe, a research strategy to improve the situation of, let me say, mobility generally, and of course to increase the possibility to have better acceptance of passengers, to look for green aircrafts and to look for environmental better situation. And all this together means that also seaplane operation came into the focus in order to investigate it. Is it probably possible to find some business-like orientation to start business operation in the European sense? And this is the task mainly. And with the first workshop here, the intention was to look in more detail into the operational, let me say, difficulties. And you know that the normal way of doing these kinds of analysis is really to look for the so-called SWOT analysis. So that means strengths, weaknesses, opportunities and threats. And we know from the history, from the let me say, recent history, not from the past. We are not looking into the 30th or 40th or 20th, where a lot of seaplane operation happens, of course. And especially here in Biscarrosse, you know, it's a historical place. And the historical place because Mr. Latiguer, who built a lot of seaplanes, also big seaplanes, and here Biscarrosse was the hub, the seaplane hub during the 30s, connecting Paris or France to New York and to South America and so on. So that means a historical place. But we are looking to the future, and that means seaplane operation, what is necessary to improve seaplane operation in Europe. And that was the item of the program. It is the item of the program, and here the first workshop was dealing in the very beginning with the operational experience. So what is the experience of the people? And we had, I believe, a lot of very nice papers and very interesting papers. Even we had missed two papers because of the weather conditions, the people could not fly in. But anyway, I believe we got a hell of information about operation. And we invited also people from North America and Canada, and I think also the paper given by Rittensen to say something about Seattle and Vancouver area showed us that there is a need, a market need, there is traffic possible even in let me say, bad weather conditions, because they fly then also during fog times and so on. So that means there is a possibility. And why does not happen this in Europe? And I think the other papers showed very, very clearly that there are several reasons where we have to work very hard on that to make it better or to improve it. And the main reason is most of those complain about regulation issues. And here we have really to differentiate between regulation of European organization like EASA, local authorities, maritime authorities. And I think this is really the challenge what we have to look for, let me say, for a guideline about permissions anyway. And that means including maritime permission, including local permission, including everything what permission is needed today. And in order to have a guideline, and of course one paper asked for looking for the final result. So, and the result is finally, and you know that one speaker said, okay, the only possibility is to look for one person who is in charge of everything, and hopefully it's a person in the region or in the town or in the village, and everybody will give his responsibility to that person, and then you get a stamp and that's it. I think that's a paradise situation. Of course, we would like, all of us would like this situation, but I think it's not to realize. So that means we have to look carefully what is the political situation. We have to look carefully what are the influences of the different authorities, and we have to work hard on that. Coming back to your question, the workshop, in our opinion, was really a great success. And we got a lot of discussions, and we had a lot of discussion in several items. We found out where really the problems are, or better to say, we have a better feeling where the problems are now, and also some fundamentals. And we will work on that in order to create then the next step. And the next step is to structure all this problematic area, to structure the threats and the weaknesses, and then to look really for a concept to improve all this situation. And then probably and hopefully we will get to some opportunities in order to increase and to improve the situation of seaplane operation in Europe. The overall program, which was agreed and approved by the EC and by the evaluators of the EC research programs, the content of that proposal, what we did, was that we try to make three workshops, and the workshop shall happen and should happen in the main, let me say, water areas in Europe. And the main water areas are the Atlantic side, the Mediterranean, and the Baltic side. So that means our intention is to organize two other workshops. The second one is clear for now, and that's Malta. And also one partner coming from Malta and operator of Harbour Air Malta. So that's important. It's a home game for them. It's very important to have people knowing the environment there very well. And the Malta Air Show, it's the base there. Like here, we have Biscarrosse event. And that's a 2 years air show, happens in Malta. And we adapt our workshop to the Malta Air Show, and this happens in 16, 17th September this year. The third workshop is not yet fixed, but the intention is to do it then somewhere in the Baltic area, in Poland, Danzig area, or in the Litauen or Lettland in the Baltic homes. So that's the intention, and we will publish it, I believe, in September, something like that, where to do that. And of course, the intention is to bring stakeholders together from the different areas, and stakeholders also from the different professions. Let's cross the fingers that we have a concept then, and we have operators, successful operators. I think the most important part, and we discussed this during the discussion and plenary session as well today, is we need to turn the political wheel. And the political wheel to turn is not simple. In my opinion, the most important part is to convince the politicians that there is a business case. Business case means for the politicians to create new jobs. So, and that's very important. So that means only to say we have a fun community, that we will not get any support, is my personal opinion. We will not get any support by the politicians. So that means what we need to make good lobbyism, But also we have to prove that there is a business case. And a strong business case, giving also some performance data or some benefits in the aerial network. So that means benefits in such a way that the people can come from one location to the other quicker, simpler, with less emission and so on. That we have to create. And in that case, I believe that we can move the wheel a little bit forward in the sense of regulation, in the sense of hopefully coming up with some seaports and so on. So in 5 years from now, I believe the time is very short. So we will have a lot of improvements. I don't see that. It's a question how fast we may turn the wheel. And here, you know, we are a niche market. And the niche market means we are a minority. And politicians don't look to minorities. They look to the majority. So, and that is how we can make the right lobbyism, how we can make a business case investigation to present then the politicians right concepts. So that we try, the first step with the existing FUSETRA program and what we already discussed, we will try of course in the case that we proceed and that we succeed end of this year, beginning of next year, that we probably will start then a follow-up program, because in 1.5 years you cannot turn the world from one end to the other. So that's not important. But anyway, we have to start and we have to push momentum on that.